That was dope.
I did one of these camera bag videos last year, but a lot has changed since then. Production value's really gone up. I got a camera right there, back here. I even have one down here. Got one over there. There's even one outside. All right, first off, I know there's some of you that are not interested in camera equipment. That's all good, I love you. Three kinds of people. Don't care about camera equipment, into it, ultra nerd, okay? I'm a bit of an ultra nerd. For this video, I'm gearing it more towards the second one, which is the into it, you know? This kit is all about doing the best possible video you can while being as minimal and small as possible. If you're an ultra nerd and you wanna get more into this with me, DM me and let's have a conversation about it. I love talking about that stuff. Anyways, let's get into it. First off, this is my bag. It's a Vanguard bag. It's good, it's a good bag. I like the color. No, but seriously, this bag can fit all my stuff. I will be upgrading to the new Peter McKinnon Nomadic bag because it is fantastic. But this is a good bag for now. It fits everything. We are gonna start off with the backbone of the operation, which is my laptop. This is a 2015 MacBook Pro. I'm not gonna get into the specs of it because that's boring, but it does a fantastic job. It's been literally perfect for me. I think I got this for $1,300 secondhand, and it has been a fantastic investment. The only thing I don't like about this is, since I was on a bit of a budget at the time, I had to spend a little less, which means I got a little less storage, but the specs are fantastic. The only problem is I have 256 gigabytes of storage, which is a very easy problem to solve by this. This is a 4 terabyte hard drive. It's a rugged, lacy, rugged, I don't know, it's decent. The one problem with it that I have is this one, because this one broke and this is a replacement. These have a fantastic reputation, but they can break, so, I mean, that's with everything. Moving on to my drone, which is a Mavic Air. This thing is fantastic. In my opinion, it's a lot better than the Pro. It's a great little drone, and I got the Flymore kit with it, just because it's nice to have an extra battery or two when you're out shooting and, you know, you just need that shot, you know? Now we're gonna move on to this. This is like the glue that keeps my kit together. This has every single cord I could ever need. It has extra SD cards, it's got a polishing thingy. It has this, which is fantastic. This is an SD to Lightning reader, so if you want to import photos very fast, you just plug your SD card right in here into your phone, and it's fantastic. If you want to even try to do daily photos, you need one of those. I always keep a socket adapter with me, just in case. Okay, moving on, I have this, which is the DJI... Moving on, I have this, which is the DJI Ronin S. This is my stabilizer. This is used for professional shoots. I'm not gonna lie, I don't really use this much for YouTube because it's either run and gun or I'm shooting at 120 FPS on this, which is smooth enough. But for professional shoots, this is a must. You just, it's a different thing to show up with an entire rig than it is just with a handheld camera. It makes me a lot more confident, as well as it makes my shots look a lot more smooth. So, coming up next, I have the Joby GorillaPod 5K. This thing is good. It's great for vlogging. It's kind of, I don't want to say unreliable, because it's good. I really like it. I love how durable it is. I could throw this thing off a building and it'd be fine. It's great to wrap around stuff, but it does tend to slide down after a while, which is kind of annoying. But it does the job. Moving on to lens number one. This is the Sony Zeiss 16-35 f/4. This is for my wide-angle shots, any wide-angle shots that you see were either taken on my phone or on this. This thing's great for real estate shoots, this thing's great for vlogging. Super sharp, super dope, fantastic autofocus, no complaints. And moving on to this. This is my iPhone 11 Pro, 64 gigabytes. It is fantastic. I got it for the three cameras because, to be honest, it's too good. I have never had the new iPhone until now, and I had to buy it. This shot were all filmed with this, which is insane. When faced with the question, is this better than the camera I'm recording on? It's not, okay? Don't get me wrong, it will never replace what I'm filming on. That being said, for a smartphone, my God, this is good. And it's completely usable footage too. That's the most important thing, is that the footage out of this is usable. Now, I can't show you this here, but there's gonna be some B-roll over top. So, what I'm shooting on is the Tamron 28-75 f2.8. That is the lens on my camera. It is fantastic. This lens is used for like close-up bokeh shots. This is like, this is my favorite lens because it's just so, you just get that blurry background and it's just, The mic I'm recording this on is the Rode Video Micro. It was super cheap and it's a great mic. This mic is actually one of the few things that has remained from my last camera kit. Last but definitely not least, I'm shooting on the Sony a7 III. It is such a dope camera for a couple of reasons. Number one, it's a fantastic hybrid camera. If I need to take photos on this, it is great. It does 10 FPS silent. And then video, obviously it's fantastic. 120 FPS, B-roll feels like I'm cheating, and it does 4K, that's always nice. It's just a great camera, and it's all I need right now. My one complaint about this camera is that the screen is a piece of shit. The screen is not very good. I find the screen tends to be inaccurate, and the touch responsiveness is kind of icky. You can't use touch in the menu. It's just kind of, the screen is not great, which, to be honest, isn't that huge of a deal, because it's mostly used for composition. If you know how to shoot in certain lighting conditions anyways, you should be fine. But I think I will be buying an external monitor for myself because it's just not accurate. Okay, I think that's it. Now, let me explain why this kit is so great, okay? I got this kit for professional shoots, travel vlogs, and just like normal YouTube videos, ones like these. This kit pretty much has every single thing you might need as a videographer in the most compact form possible. So for an example, the lenses I have, right? I only have two. I actually downgraded from four. Reason why is because I have a good focal length for wide shots with this, as well as a good focal length for tight shots with that. Don't really need any more than 78 for myself at least. We got storage, we got power on the laptop, we got stabilization if you need it. I also heard the Ronin SC was good, but I tried running it, it had little micro jiggles, so I don't know, look into that. I'm not gonna look into that. Let me know if you think there's pieces of my kit that could be switched out for better ones. Maybe there's a piece in here that's not doing quite as good of a job as it could. Ask me questions in my DMs, comment below your thoughts and opinions on things, if you think I'm wrong or if you think I'm right. Anything, do it. Other than that, thank you guys so much for 5K. The growth lately on this channel has been ridiculous, and I love and appreciate every single one of you. Just taking a second, it's been just crazy this past week or so. Thank you so much for your support. Everyone new here, welcome, what's going on? And everyone old here, thanks for sticking with me. I'll see you in the next video. Hey.